Welcome to Jones TV, and welcome to DCW Drive. We're live here in the capacity crowd of Phoenix, Arizona. Will Kara be able to take down Nate Osborne? Will be able to avenge his father? Or will the Motor City Madman madness continue? First matchup tonight, a DCW Drive. We have the Motor City Madman, Nate Osborne, taking on a newcomer here in DCW. As Nate Osborne making his way into the arena, he is living up to the moniker of a madman here lately in DCW. Continuously attacking Eddie Kang. Starting after this victory at Vice, attacking him from behind and throwing him into the steel steps. Up until our last episode at Saturday Night Unleashed, where he tapped him from behind in the back before his matchup with Lance Bourne, hitting him with vicious chair shots, telling him that he wants a Kara as Nate Osborne, walking up the steps to get into the ring to take on one of the newest competitors here of the DCW. Akira, who is also Eddie Kang's son, which is why he's been attacking Eddie Kang so much. He's been hearing all the fanfare for Akira for the past couple of months. He wants to prove a point that he can take him down here in DCW. Kara is making his way into the arena. You can barely see his face under that hood and the lights in the arena. But I can guarantee you that he definitely wants to exact some revenge on the Nate Osborne for attacking his father, Eddie Kang, for the last couple weeks. This is a Kara debut matchup here in DCW, live in Phoenix, Arizona. Taking on the man that's been attacking his father for the past few weeks. As the light finally shines on Akira. The man is making a lot of noise in Japan before coming to DCW. Let's see what this young man here has when he takes on the Motor City Madman, Nate Osborne. First matchup, Nate Osborne versus Akira. And here we go. Tie up with the two men. Nate with an advantage. Working on a wrist lock here. Nate continuously showing his wrestling prowess in the early goings of this matchup. Trying to show Akira what it's all about in DCW. He takes down Akira with an electric chair. Nate trying to set up Akira with a snap suplex and he got him. Nate Osborne wants to prove a point that he is the man in DCW. He's trying to show it to his youngster right here as Akira swings back around. The knee to the gut by Akira and a shot to the chest area as well. Akira trying to pick up Bourne on his feet. Kicks and strikes to the chest and the head area. of the Motor City Madman. A carry to the outside, slingshots in with a leg drop. And now Kerosene is in control. This first matchup here in DCW. Another headshot with a knee. Cover. One. One count. Kick out by Nate Osborne. Nate Osborne with a quick kick out. Akira's trying to set him up. Nate escapes. Nate trying to go for a chop. But Akira counters. Nate with a headshot to the back of the head. And a sidewalk slam to take down Akira. As the crowd's coming alive here in Phoenix, Arizona. And Nate Osborne with a net breaker onto Akira. Osborne, we're going to neck of Akira. Try to set him up for a potential tombstone pile driver. Or even worse, setting up for a final ride. And Akira moves out of the way of the elbow drop. Shot in the gut by Osborne. Picks him up. Heading for a powerbomb. Akira with shots. Akira trying to get out of a powerbomb, and he does. But Nate with a quick shot. The back suplex by the North Sea Madman. Nate Osborne continues to attack Akira in this matchup right here. A shot to the face. DDT by Osborne. Stomping out Akira. Akira gotta make some moves very quickly. Or it could be an early night for the man. Akira with an elbow shot. Picks him up on his shoulders. Reverse by Osborne. Reverse DDT. Reverse DDT by Nate Osborne. Dragging Akira to the middle of the ring. And a shot to the midsection with a big boot for Nate Osborne. Headshots. Going for the cover. One. One count. Kick out by Akira. Akira with a quick kick out. Followed with a shot to the gut. Osborne trying to pick him up. Clothesline by Osborne. A clothesline by Osborne takes down Akira. But it seemed like the young man was getting some momentum in this matchup. But Akira with an uppercut. Try to pick up Osborne. Takes him down with a Michinoku driver. Headed to the second rope. Nate Osborne trying to get to his feet. Akira's there waiting on him. Akira on top. Drop kick for the second rope. Akira stomping out. Nate Osborne going for a dragon sleeper. A dragon sleeper. Is Nate Osborne going to tap out? But Nate Osborne powers out of the dragon sleeper. Snap there, takedown by Akira. Nate Osborne reverses it with a shot to the face. Osborne with a quick DDT. And now the Motor City Madman's in control of this matchup. Telling Akira to get to his feet on the second rope. Double axe handle takedown. Nate Osborne looking at Akira on the shoulders. Showing him great strength here with a gorilla press. Going for the cover. One. One count. Kick out once again by Akira. Akira showing a lot of fight in his first matchup in DCW. You can feel Nate Osborne getting frustrated. He's setting up Akira. Set up a tombstone pile driver. A tombstone pile driver on Akira. Osborne trying to do more damage here. Shot to the face. Akira reverse whatever hold the Osborne trying to go for. A big clothesline to the back of the head. Akira with shots and quick feet. It's like he's dead and a shot to the head. A vicious knee to the head of Nate Osborne. Akira showing signs that he's dead. But finishing off with that big knee. But now Nate Osborne's back in control. Osborne got him up. Looking for a final round reversal. Reverse DDT by Akira. Akira reversed the final ride. Akira's onto the outside. Telling Osborne to get up. Setting up springboard. AK-47. AK-47 by Akira. Cover. One, two, Kano! Akira hit with that springboard knee. Then he calls it AK-47. Nate Osborne barely escapes it. What is Akira going to do here to follow that up with? Picks up Osborne on the shoulders. Drops him right back down to the mat. Akira going to the outside again. He's trying to get Nate Osborne to get up. Osborne's getting to his feet. He's looking for another AK-47. Goes for it. Connects it. The second AK-47 is matched up. Going for the cover. One, two, three. And Akira with an impressive debut here in DCW at DCW Drive. And Nate Osborne showing his strength. But as I said, but Akira's had a kick out of that move. Going for a tombstone pile driver. He kicked out of that one. Hitting him with vicious shots. Falling over that knee. And then took two, not one, but two AK-47s to take down Nate Osborne. As you can see, the second one right there, folks, taking down the Motor City Madman for the one, the two, the three. As Akira is celebrating his first victory here and making some vengeance for his dad at DCW Drive. Next matchup has a lot of bad blood involved, as this man, Steven Lewis, makes his way into the arena. He is the reason, I won't say the sole reason, but he is the one of the major reasons that Jeremy Storm lost his matchup against Eric Taylor at Summer Madness. Steven Lewis is the main enforcer of fortitude, as they see as Jeremy Storm being somewhat of a pest to them, because Jeremy Storm returned a favor at Vice, ultimately costing Eric Taylor the world championship by giving him the Storm Bomb with about less than 2 minutes to go in the matchup, and he's in control of the time before being taken out, and Isaac Nagy took advantage to become the new DCW world champion. As Steven Lewis makes his way around the ring before getting into it, he's going to have to be ready. But seeing how quick he disposed his opponent the last time we saw him on Saturday Night Unleashed, I'm pretty sure he's more than ready for this matchup against a former DCW Internet Champion and Jeremy Storm. As Steven Lewis is in the ring, getting warmed up before this matchup, waiting on the former member of Fortitude to make his way into the ring. As Jeremy Storm walks out with no theme music, little to no fanfare, showing everybody in Phoenix, Arizona, that he means business. Jeremy Storm, the former member of Fortitude, a former DCW Internet Champion, a former DCW Tag Team Champion with Fortitude. He is a man on an island by himself against his powerful faction known as Fortitude. as Eric Taylor kicked him out because he thought Jeremy Storm was getting too much of the spotlight. Eric Taylor's not competing tonight, but he's showing support to the newest member of 42, Steven Lewis, in his first pay-per-view matchup here in DCW. As Jeremy Storm walks around the ring, looking ready and determined to take down his opponent, pacing back and forth. He knows how big of the moment this is for him, considering what happened to him at Summer Madness. It'll be Steven Lewis versus Jeremy Storm. And here we go. The two-man tie-up. Steven Lewis has him in a headlock. Storm's trying to get out of it. Iron Whip comes back around Lewis. Clothesline takedown by Jeremy Storm. It's Storm working on the body of Steven Lewis. These are two powerhouses here in DCW. Storm doing an unlucky thing here, going towards the top. Off the top rope. Leg drop off the top by Jeremy Storm. Looks like he has Steven Lewis reeling here. Storm picks him up. Follow-away slam by the former member of Fortitude. Isaiah Taylor is trying to distract Jeremy Storm right now. Steven Lewis trying to take full advantage with that suplex there. Steven Lewis following it up with elbow drops and shots to the back. Try to make him more vulnerable here for that devastating finishing maneuver that he has. Shots to the face by Steven. Trying to pick up Jeremy. Got him up for a suplex. Jeremy coming around, shot to the face. Oh no, reverse. Steven going for a reverse, but Jeremy countered it. Takes him down with a slam. Steven trying to get a second win. Trying to run away from Jeremy, it looks like. Jeremy caught him. Irish whip, come back around. Shot to the face. Another shot, and another shot. Lewis with a counter. And he takes him down with that suplex. Trying to get him, Jeremy. Headshots with elbow drops right into the head of Storm. Steven Lewis going to the outside. Look for another breather. Comes back in. Trying to stomp out Jeremy. But Jeremy's trying to get away here. Lewis is pacing around the ring like he can do what he wants to do. Yelling at Jeremy Storm to get to his feet. Off the second rope, drop kick but missed. He missed the drop kick, he was going on Storm. And now Storm's trying to take full advantage. Trying to drag Steven Lewis around the ring. Takes him down with a snap there. Now working on the upper body, on the shoulder area. A new member of Fortitude. Is Eric Taylor looking on? Not liking what he's seeing right now. But Steven Lewis with a short arm, shoulder block. Stomping out Jeremy. And now showing a little bit of wrestling tactician that he is. Having some amateur wrestling background. Well, oh! Jeremy Storm with a belly-to-belly takedown. Jeremy Storm trying to get a little payback for having that Summer Madness. When you seem like you have full control of Eric Taylor before going to the outside. And being attacked by Steven Lewis before losing that matchup. The Storm with a headlock. See now he's trying to take control of this matchup here with Steven Lewis. But Lewis up on his feet. Shot to the gut. Another shot. Getting Jeremy at least to hold. Got Storm up. No, Storm reverses into a reverse DDT. This matchup has been all about strength pretty much. The shot in the head by Jeremy Storm. Storm with a boot to the gut of Steven Lewis. As I was saying, this match has been all about strength for the most part. And Jeremy Storm trying to show his strength here, trying to make Steven Lewis submit to the camel clutch. As he's working on the back of the neck area of Steven Lewis, he's able to counter. Oh, he counters it. Steve Lewis counted it. Trying to go for a net breaker. Counted by Jeremy. Jeremy's picking up Lewis. Another faraway slam. Another faraway slam by Storm. Lewis with a shoulder block takedown. Going for the quick cover. One count kick out on Jeremy Storm. And a kick to the gut by Steven Lewis. You can tell he's getting frustrated here. Keep kicking and stomping out Jeremy Storm. Keep giving him all the boots. Steven Lewis trying to tire out and take down Storm. But Storm's trying to do the same to Lewis with a power driver. A mean power driver by Jeremy Storm. Storm's setting him up. He's looking for it. OKC Buster. OKC Buster. By Jeremy Storm. Trying to pick up Steven Lewis off the mat. Lewis with a shot to the gut. Lewis is back to his feet. Picks up Storm. Powerbomb. A powerbomb by Lewis. As he goes to the turnbuckle and relaxes a little bit. Double axe handle. Right into the face of Storm. And the knee drop to follow that up. Storm with an uppercut. Storm with a shot. Storm's looking for it. Storm got it up. Storm bomb. Storm bomb by Jeremy. 1-2-3-0. Steven Lewis barely kicked out of the Storm bomb. Jeremy's arguing with the referee. Steven Lewis trying to take advantage now, work on the leg of Storm. The crowd's on his feet here in Phoenix. Lewis taking down Storm. Lewis with the same move to the Storm. Back of Storm Madness. 2. Kick out by Storm. A kick out by Storm. Storm kicked out a count of 2. Steven Lewis still trying to work on him. Snap suplex. As the enforcer of Fortitude showing off his strength and his prowess here at DCW Drive. Oh no. Got Storm to take Storm down. That's the move he took out Storm with at Summer Madness. 1-2-3. And Steven Lewis is a victor in his hard-fought matchup at DCW Drive. It seemed like Jeremy Storm had come into victory, hitting with the OKC Buster and the Storm Bomb, but somehow Steven Lewis kicked out of it. It hit him with that devastating move, the same move he knocked him out with at Summer Madness, and takes him down for the 1, 2, 3. That move right there took out Jeremy Storm here tonight. As Fortitude at DCW Drive reigns supreme. Is there any way stopping this force at DCW with their newest enforcer, Steven Lewis? This man has been on a vicious run as of late in DCW. The natural born thriller, Lance Bourne, and he makes his way down the ramp, has been on a mission per se to take out Jack Gunn, the man that he thinks had cost him the DCW World Championship at DCW Vice. And the two men is battling it out all throughout the Las Vegas arena until Jack Gunn hit with the Aval Bomb through a table, taking both competitors out, costing both of them a chance to become the DCW World Champion. They also had a chance to be the Tag Team Champions the following Saturday Night Unleashed when they lost that match against La Familia. And that's when Lance Bourne gave Jack Gunn a Bourne kick, robbing him into the back. And those two men have been down each other's throats ever since, with Jack Gunn having so far having a one-up on Lance Bourne, attacking him our last show on Saturday Night Unleashed. As Lance Bourne waiting for the bone picker to make his way into the ring. Jack Gunn, the man that took out Lance Bourne at DCW Vice, that took out Lance Bourne in the latest episode on Saturday Night Unleashed with some mean, vicious apple bombs, with the one being at Vice going through a table, costing Lance Bourne the World Championship. And they couldn't coexist long enough to win the tag team titles. So now we have a one-on-one matchup here at DCW Vice, where Jack Gunn will take on Lance Bourne. Lance Bourne looks ready. Jack Gunn looks ready. And here we go. Jack Gunn throws Lance Bourne across the ring to start this match off with, following it up with headshots, with fists to the face of the Natural Born Thriller. Jack Gunn got a considerable size advantage against Lance Bourne. He is clearly using that power against the Natural Born Thriller. And a shot to the gut by the bone picker himself, picking off Lance Bourne all over the ring in the early goings of this matchup. Gunn picking Bourne off the mat and throws him right back down, head first. The bone picker's in full control, but Bourne with a counter, throwing him to the turnbuckle. Now throwing him to the steel post, right into his shoulder. Kicks to the chest area in the corner, and he takes down Jack Gunn. This could be the opening that Lance Bourne is looking for to try to take over this matchup, going towards the outside. Jack Gunn's trying to get to his feet. Bourne with a springboard and a knee to the face. A springboard knee by Lance Bourne on the Jack Gunn. Going for a cutter, but Jack Gunn powers out of it. Jack Gunn with a running DDT to take down a Natural Born Thriller. Arm drag for Lance Bourne. He falls over the DDT of his own. This turns into a back and forth matchup in the two. As Bourne going for another cutter, but Gunn reverses, and Gunn shows his power. But Bourne reverses into a sunset flip. One count kick out by Jack Gunn. But seems like Bourne trying to get a sneaky win here with that counter going to a sunset flip. But now Gunn's trying to take advantage. As Gunn's trying to set up Bourne up top, Gunn's going for a superplex. A superplex by Jack Gunn, taking down the Natural Born Thriller. Going for the cover. One count kick out by Lance Bourne. A couple of quick kickouts by the competitors tonight. Gunn with boots. Gunn trying to set up Bourne, hooking him in for the camel clutch. Trying to make Bourne submit here. Has in the middle of the ring, but Bourne counters out of it. Bourne squirms his way out of the camel clutch. The two men countering moves back and forth there. Selena Del Sol by Bourne. One count kick out by Jack Gunn. Bourne's going for a high risk and he misses. Cover by Gunn. One count kick out by Lance Bourne. A shot to the back by Gunn. It didn't look like it fazed Bourne at all. Gunn trying to use his strength here. Drops Lance Bourne on the ropes. Bourne with a jawbreaker. Bourne with a swing around. DDT takes him down. And Nacho Bourne Thriller has the upper hand on the bone picker here in Phoenix, Arizona at DCW Drive. Bourne run Rick in the eyes. Try to go for a German. Counter by Gunn. Shot to the back by Gunn. Trick shot by Gunn. Gunn with a trick shot. And he's signaling for the end of this matchup. Possibly looking for an elbow bomb. And if Gunn's able to get an elbow bomb, it'll be over with a knee to the face of Jack Gunn. Gunn setting him up for the elbow bomb. And he takes Lance Bourne down. That should be it. Going for the cover. One, two, no, two count. A two count before the kick out by Lance Bourne. As Gunn's arguing with the referee, saying that was a slow count. Trying to drag Gunn across the ring. Headshot. A vicious fist to the head by Jack Gunn. Bourne's on his feet. Shot by Bourne. Knee to the face by Bourne. Going for the cover. One, two, kick out by Gunn. A kick out by Gunn. And Bourne can't believe it. Bourne's messing with the crowd. Gunn is slowly getting to his feet. Gunn is on his feet and clothesline takes him down. The clothesline by Bourne knocks the big man down with boots to the back by the Nacho Bourne Thriller. Another shot to the back. Lance Bourne trying to set him up. He got the Aussie lock hooked in. The Aussie lock is hooked in. And Jack Gunn taps out. Jack Gunn taps out to the Aussie lock. And Lance Bourne is the winner of this matchup. I thought it was over, folks, when Jack Gunn hit him with the elbow bomb. But then Lance Bourne hit him with that knee. Then following it up with the Aussie lock to make Jack Gunn tap out. And your winner of this matchup is the Nacho Bourne Thriller, Lance Bourne. One of the most anticipated matchups ever in DCW history. The Ayatollah of Rock and Rolla. The self-proclaimed GOAT of wrestling. Chris Jericho makes his DCW debut tonight at DCW Drive to take on perhaps the greatest wrestler in DCW history, Will Nunn. Chris Jericho, a couple episodes back on Saturday Night Unleashed, cost Will Nunn the chance to be number one contender for the DCW World Championship. Now Chris Jericho, Eric Lee walks down the aisle right now. before getting into the ring. He had a message for Will Nunn, telling him why he did it, saying that he thinks that Will Nunn is overrated, that he has not beaten the competitors that Chris Jericho has beaten, and that he can prove that Will Nunn is second to Jericho. As the master of this class, Will, second to none, makes his way down to the ring. The first time being on pay-per-view since the beginning of DCW Unbeaten, without being the DCW World Champion. And it seems like with the attire that he is wearing, he's sending a signal to Chris Jericho, telling him that he's the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be, at least in DCW. As Will Nunn makes his way into the ring, in the capacity crowd of Phoenix, Arizona, tonight here at DCW Drive. This match could potentially be one for the ages here. Between Chris Jericho and Will Nunn. And here we go. Jericho arrogantly running the ropes with a quick DDT by Jericho on the Will Nunn. With boots to the back by the Ayatollah Rock and Roller. And he takes down Will Nunn, trying to show him that he is the best at what he does. Will Nunn gets out of the headlock, comes back around Jericho, takes him down with a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker, does Will Nunn, as he has something to prove here tonight, after losing the DCW World Championship at DCW Vice, under crazy circumstances. It looks to like that Will Nunn had the championship won until Najee came out of nowhere, knocked him off the top rope, and took full advantage to become the new World Champion. As Will Nunn with a shot to the gut under Jericho, swinging around to a net breaker. Now we're going to armor Jericho. If Jericho has any advantage in this matchup, it is his experience inside that square circle. But it seems to be right now, experience has nothing to do with this matchup. But Will Nunn with a backbreaker onto Chris Jericho. The self-proclaimed best ever. He's taking full control of this matchup. Going toward the second rope. Jericho trying to get to his feet. The crowd getting to his feet as well here. If he's Arizona. Nunn begins working on the knee of Chris Jericho. Possibly going to set up that inverted sharpshooter that he has. From my recollection, he only won one match with that move. And that was against Eric Taylor at DCW Limelight. As Will Nunn, waiting for Jericho to get up onto his feet. Jericho trying to get himself up on the ropes. He knocks Jericho out to the outside, round to the front of the announce table. He's telling Jericho to get to his feet. Jericho's trying to get up. We're at a count of two. At a count of three, as Nunn hits him with a back suplex. As the referee starts his count again on the count of one. As Nunn keeps trying to dish out more punishment. We're at a count of two. Count of three. As Will Nunn runs Jericho into the barricade. Will Nunn picks up Jericho. Drops his head into the barricade. Nunn is just dealing out all the damage in this matchup here. I believe we're on a count of five. Count of six now. Throws Jericho back in the ring. Nunn is back in the ring on a count of seven. Now Nunn locking in a dragon sleeper. Trying to make Jericho submit, but Jericho gets out of it. Jericho with a quick shot to the gut with a boot. Bat suplex by Chris Jericho. And there goes Chris Jericho, being as arrogant as ever, thinking he has the match at hand. Did he not learn how quickly it turned for him in the early goings? He might learn now, as Dunn is doing shots to the gut with elbows. Jericho, Irish whip to the corner. Jericho trying to pick up, none to the top. They're both going up top. Because Jericho is more a high risk, high reward maneuver, and a superplex by Chris Jericho. A superplex by Chris Jericho. And Jericho with a slap to the face. Jericho being disrespectful with a slap to the face by Nunn. Jericho with shoulder blocks. Nunn trying to throw up to the top. Jericho hangs on. Jericho to the top himself. Jericho the double axe handle takedown. Jericho showing everybody why he's one of the best at what he does. And Jericho trying to set in. Jericho with the walls of Jericho. Locked in. Middle of the ring. Nunn has nowhere to go. Nunn has nowhere to go. But Nunn powers out of it. Will Nunn powers out of walls of Jericho. Will Nunn's headed to the top rope. Will Nunn with a drop kick from the top rope. Taking down Jericho. And just like that, the advantage of the matchup goes to Will Nunn. Nunn going for another dragon sleeper on the Chris Jericho. And then Jericho powers it out once again. Jericho with a close. Oh! Jericho's going for a clothesline. Nunn reversed into a back body drop to the outside. Rest at a count of two. Jericho is stunned right now. Count of three. Jericho comes back in. Jericho with a code breaker. Jericho with a quick code breaker. One, two, no, no. Nunn kicked out a code breaker. Jericho's irate right now. And now Jericho's going for a dragon sleeper, and Will Nunn counters it with knees to the face. Jericho with a snap near takedown. We're gonna headlock onto Will Nunn. Jericho firmly got the hole locked in. Nunn's trying to figure a way to get out. As Jericho keeps wrenching on the neck and the head area of Will Nunn, and Nunn counters it into his own headlock. The two men finally break up. Jericho got him up. And Jericho drops him to the turnbuckle. Jericho's trying to go for a boot. But Nunn is countering it. Takes down Chris Jericho. Nunn with a shot to the back. Jericho with an uppercut. Jericho trying to go for a backbreaker. Counter by Nunn. Nunn go for a double underhook suplex and got him. Nunn hit with a double underhook suplex. Nunn going for the kicks of glory. Shot square into the chest of Jericho. And that final shot to the head of Chris Jericho. Jericho's back up with an uppercut. Jericho picks up Nunn. Nunn counters it. Neck breaker by Nunn. Nunn going for the cover. One, two, kick out by Jericho. Kick out by Chris Jericho. Nunn's waiting for Jericho to get to his feet. Nunn picks up Jericho. Nunn to the shot to the gut. Runs the ropes. Finish line, finish line, finish line. Cover, one, two, no! Jericho kicked out of the count of two. Jericho kicked out of the finish line. Just like Nunn kicked out of the code breaker. Shot in the back by Nunn. Nunn tried to go for a DDT and he got it. Nunn with a springboard splat. No! Nunn trying to go for a springboard leg drop but miss. And now Nunn's messing with the crowd here in Phoenix, Arizona. Chris Jericho like he's out. Jericho with a jawbreaker. Jericho with a running knee. Nunn with a boot to the face. Nunn going for a cover. One, two, kick out by Jericho. Nunn working on the knees of Chris Jericho now. Nunn running the ropes. Double axe handle missed by Nunn. Jericho taking down Will Nunn. Jericho looking for the walls of Jericho again. Can he turn him over? He got him. Walls of Jericho, middle of the ring once again onto Will Nunn. But Nunn able to resist it. Nunn powers out of it for the second time in this matchup. Nunn got a walls of Jericho. Reverse DDT by Will Nunn. Reverse DDT. One, two, kick out by Jericho. All these near falls between these two great competitors of the night. By Chris Jericho and Will Nunn. Nunn's going toward the second rope. Jericho trying to get into his feet. The crowd here in Phoenix is on their feet. Drop kick by Nunn. Nunn picking up Jericho. Nunn takes down Jericho. Jericho back on his feet. Jericho with a takedown, going for a headlock. Trying to slow the pace down this matchup. Nunn gets out of the headlock. And Jericho once again taunting to the crowd. But Nunn is still out. Jericho waiting for Nunn to get up. Jericho going for the code breaker and he got it. The second code breaker in this matchup. Covered by Jericho. One, two, kick out by Nunn. Nunn with another kick out. Jericho hitting the mat in frustration as Nunn kicked out of the code breaker for a second time. Jericho with a senton splash. What is Chris Jericho going to do? He's working on a leg of Nunn right here. And Nunn is in excruciating pain, beating the walls of Jericho twice tonight. Jericho picking up Will Nunn. What is Jericho going to do? Picking up Nunn off his shoulders. Nunn counters. Nunn with another reverse DDT on the Chris Jericho. Will Nunn be able to pull off the big victory here tonight at DCW Drive, attacking Chris Jericho's knee. Nunn with a slam, going for a cover. One, two, kick out by Jericho. Kick out by Jericho. Nunn runs the ropes, hit him with a double axe handle. Shot in the back by Nunn. Jericho's back on his feet. Jericho going for a double underhook suplex himself, but countered by Nunn. Nunn stomping out Chris Jericho's chest. Nunn wants to show Chris Jericho that he is the best in DCW with that suplex taking down Chris Jericho. Trying to show Jericho that championship run wasn't a fluke. As Jericho countered the cutter. Nunn countered that boot. as Nunn continuously taps the legs of Chris Jericho here. Going for the cover. One, two, kick out by Jericho. What more? How much more can these two men can take in this matchup? Nunn going for another cutter. Cut out by Jericho. Jericho going for another. Oh! Jericho with a double hook DDT. Jericho with a double arm hook DDT. And now he's setting for the Walls of Jericho again. The Walls of Jericho for the third time. Dead center in the ring. Nunn has nowhere to go. Nunn has the power up. Nunn taps out. Nunn tapped out. Will Nunn tapped out to the Walls of Jericho? Jericho hitting him with two code breakers. Had him hooked in for three Walls of Jericho. And the third one is for the charm. And Chris Jericho may Will Nunn tap out. Chris Jericho to show DCW in the world why he calls himself the GOAT. Our next matchup is for the DCW Internet Championship. As Ricky Heathen makes his appearance in DCW Drive live in Phoenix, Arizona. He had an opportunity to win this championship at DCW Saturday Night Unleashed, but came up just short against the champion Pablo Juarez before Conan Capano came out of nowhere and took out Riddick Heathen with a tidal wave onto the ramp before attacking Pablo Juarez and running him through the barricade of Saturday Night Unleashed, which is why this DCW Internet Championship matchup will be a triple threat against these three men. As Ricky Heathen looks onto his Heatheners at a shot to become a champion in DCW. As the Hawaiian Poseidon, the Wave God, Conan Capano, making his way down the ramp. That man has been on a destructive path in DCW, taking out everything that moves after losing out of the DCW World Championship at Vice, where he rammed Ricky Heathen through the barricade. And he took out Ricky Heathen on the last episode of Saturday Night Unleashed with a tidal wave onto the ramp. As Conan Capano has opportunity here to become the new DCW Internet Champion. As you can feel his presence being felt here tonight in Phoenix, Arizona. But does he have the drive to win that title? as the El Patron of Mexico and your DCW Internet Champion, Pablo Juarez, makes his way into the arena. He's been a fighting champion since become the Internet Champion. Taking on all comers, with the last opponent being Ricky Heathen at Saturday Night Unleashed, before Tony Capano unleashed his tidal wave of terror on both opponents here tonight. This will be a triple threat matchup for that belt that you see around Pablo Juarez's waist for the Internet Championship, which has already been a crazy night here at DCW Drive. We have to wait and see what happens in this matchup, folks. As Pablo's in the ring, getting ready for the... Oh my God! He's back, ladies and gentlemen. Vitor Silva is back in DCW. Silva's making his way down to the ring. What is he doing here? Wait a minute. I'm getting word from the back that Trent Sens made this match into a four-way elimination match and put Vitor Silva into this matchup to see who'll come out on top as DCW Internet Champion. And what a way for Vitor Silva to come back in a title matchup for the first and only title he's ever won in DCW, the Internet Championship. I still can't believe it, folks, that he's back. In this four-way matchup, it is Ricky Heathen, Tony Capano, Pablo Juarez, and Vitor Silva for the Internet Championship. And here we go. It's Vitor and Capano is going towards the outside with a powerbomb by Ricky Heathen. Ricky Heathen with a quick powerbomb on the Pablo Juarez. There are two men battling the outside and two men battling the inside. As Ricky Heathen hit Pablo with a net breaker. And it seemed like Vitor got control of Capano on the outside. What an unexpected turn of events here at DCW Drive. It's went from a three-way title match to a four-way elimination. As Cardo picks up Vitor and sends him down the floor. It is absolute pandemonium in this matchup. A moonsault from the apron. Ricky Heathen hits on Pablo. As the Wave God is beating up Silva. Ricky Heathen found Cardo. As Heathen hit him with shots and kicks it outside. And Cardo's fighting back on him. Powerbomb to the outside. A powerbomb onto the floor. But Cardo on the Ricky Heathen. All four men just battling it out amongst each other. There's no count outs, no disqualification. As Silva got thrown to the steel steps. Cardo got thrown to the steel steps now. Overhead belly to belly by Pablo on the Silva. As all four men are battling it on the floor. As Cardo and Pablo got ran to the steps. And a hurricanrana takedown by Silva on the Ricky Heathen. As all four men continues to battle it out. Russian leg sweep. Taking down Cardo. Pablo throwing Heathen to the steps. Pablo's on one on his feet right now. The DCW Internet Champion trying to take control of this matchup. A clothesline takedown of Ricky. Oh! Pablo with a back suplex, dropping Silva onto the steps. And these men just battling everywhere on the floor. This match is so crazy I can't even call it. Just battling all over the place. Olympic slam by Pablo. It's Kono and Ricky Heathen goes back into the ring. Pablo's back into the ring. But Pablo goes back outside. Arm drag by Ricky Heathen. As Pablo and Victor fight on the outside. Heathen and Kono fighting inside. Heathen with a baseball slide. Hurricane on a takedown on the Kono. Pablo keeps thinking about going back into the ring. We're seeing Silver on the ground, takes full advantage with boots to the midsection. Ricky trying to hang back into the ring. The shot to the outside. Now four men are out to the outside once again. Elbow drop by Kono. Drop kick by Silver. It has been absolute pandemonium since the bell rang in this four-way elimination match. As Kono is hitting Ricky Heathen with Vance Master suplexes. As Vitor stomping out Pablo on the other side. You see like the two men have switched off. But Vitor trying to attack Heathen, but Heathen with a shoulder block. Heathen throwing Kono to the other side of the floor of the arena. As Silver goes back in and Pablo's back into the ring. Heathen's back into the ring. Heathen got Pablo on the shoulders. Drops Pablo onto the ropes. Silver went for the springboard. Leg drop but missed. Heathen tried to take advantage, but no. Kono cuts him off. Now Kono tried to go for a shot, but Heathen reverses. Heathen picks up Kono. Silver breaks it up. Silver throws Heathen to the corner. Heathen trying to counter both men. Heathen trying to fight off both competitors. Double DDT by Silver and Kono. Knee drop by Pablo. Silver's up top. Decided to change his mind. Knocks Pablo to the floor. Knocks Kono to the floor. Pablo springboards in with a rolling senton. Working on the arm of Heathen. As Silva and Kono fight on the outside. Pablo going for a power bomb and it connects. He holds on to Heathen. Going for a second power bomb. That connects. He do it for a third time. And he got that one. Three power bombs in a row by Pablo Juarez. Having Heathen dead in the middle of the ring. Springboard frog splash on the Heathen. A springboard frog splash on the Ricky Heathen. This could be the end for Ricky soon in this matchup. As Kono and Silva back and forth. Heathen with a clothesline taking down Pablo. A counter by Silva. Heathen's trying to get Pablo up. Pablo's getting to his feet. Pablo with a counter. Pablo with an uppercut counter. The fans shout, this is awesome. One, two, three. Heathen's been eliminated with that counter by Pablo. Silver rolled out to the outside. So it's just Pablo and Cody fighting the ring now. As Heathen's been eliminated, the two men hit counter and moves in the middle of the ring. Seem to be a favorite in this matchup. Ricky Heathen is not out. As Pablo hits Kono with a German suplex, showing off his power. And a spinning heel kick by Pablo Juarez. The El Patron of Mexico is in full control of this matchup. Silva's back into the ring. As Pablo continues to work on the legs of Kono. As Silva's trying to find the right time to attack one of these opponents. Silva picking up Kono off the ground. Kono with a reversal. Pablo getting that Kono. Reverse suplex by Pablo. Kono down the ring. Over the top goes Pablo. Pablo's over the top. Vitor's the only one standing right now in the middle of the ring. Nice going outside to go after Pablo. Capallo's on the other side, trying to get his energy. Vitor's back in the ring. Pablo's back in the ring. Vitor with a boost to the leg. His first match back here at DCW since Summer Madness. Vitor going for a sunset flip powerbomb onto the floor. It's him and Kono meet each other outside. Kono tosses him into the ring post. Gets him back into the ring. Vitor like he's out right now. Kono with Samoan slam. Kono with opportunity to take down Vitor. Throws him down to the mat. Pablo's back in. Pablo working with the crowd. As Kono showing his strength here. Sit out powerbomb. Going for the cover. Pablo breaks it up. Why did Pablo break it up? Knee to the face by Vitor. By Kono. I guess Pablo will work on Vitor himself, dropping him to the ropes to interfere in this three-way matchup. Olympic slam by Pablo. It might be all over for Vitor here. And Pablo with a shot to the gut. Kono setting up Pablo. Tidal wave out of nowhere. Run to Pablo. 1, 2, 3. Pablo's been eliminated. Pablo's no longer the internet champion. It'll be between Kono Kapano and Vitor Silva. One of these two men will be the new DCW Internet Champion. Is it going to be Kono Kapano or the returning Vitor Silva will be the Internet Champion? As Kono knocked out Vitor with that clothesline. Trying to get Vitor on his feet. Vitor's like dead weight right now. Got him on the ropes here. Kono's picking him up. Drops him right into the ropes. Dropping Silva onto the ropes. Kono's looking at Silva. Like Shark looking at prey here. With the Hawaiian Poseidon, the wave god, be the new DC Internet Champion. It seems to be a possibility as he is manhandling Silva right now with a Samoan drop. And a vicious knee shot by the Hawaiian Poseidon. I don't know what's left in the tank for the Brazilian here. It's Kono behind his way with him. This has been the final two men. Oh, a counter by Silva. He was stuck in the tree. Whoa, chops. Trying to go for a punch. Kono counters. Kono picks him up and slams him down to the mat. Kono going for the cover. 1, 2, kick out by Silva. A kick out by Silva. Kono sitting there with his hands on his waist. Trying to figure out the next move here. As Vitor Silva is hanging on in this matchup. As Kono throwing them bows right to the top of the head of Silva. How much more can Vitor Silva take in this matchup? Elbow drop from the second rope. How much does he have left here? Because Kono hit him with a sit-out powerbomb. Go over the cover. 1, 2. Kick out by Silva again. Silva keeps kicking out. Silla showed everybody his first match back while he was the first ever DCW Internet Champion. And another Samoan Slam by the Hawaiian Poseidon. A Samoan Slam on the Vitor. Vitor with a counter. Vitor with a sidewinder. Vitor showed everybody that he has a little bit left in this matchup. What he's gonna do? Setting him up. Picks up Kono. Takes him down with a vertebraker. Took him down with a vertebraker. One, two, three, no! 2.5. A 2.5 off of that vertebraker. And Kono's back in control. That vertebraker might have been all that Silva had left in the tank. Kono's trying to set him up. Silva with a counter. Shot to the leg. Eyes whip by Kono. Run to the corner. Kono going to work in the back. Kono throws Silva to the turnbuckle. German suplex by the way, God. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know how much more Silva can take in his onslaught that Kono is giving him. Silva is taking his last breath to get to his feet, but he's hit with a tidal wave. A tidal wave. Round of Silva. Silva's laying motionless. The cover by Kono. 1, 2, 3. And Kono Kapano is your new DCW Internet Champion. See Pablo taking out Ricky with that uppercut. Kono taking out Pablo with the tidal wave. And then finally taking out Silva with the tidal wave for the 1, 2, 3. And the Hawaiian Poseidon, the Wave God, is your new DCW Internet Champion. Our next matchup is for the Women's Championship. Coming out first is that demonic woman right there, Dama de la Muerte. As the Lady of the Dead of DCW has a shot of a lifetime here to become the new Women's Champion. She's been on quite a tear herself here in DCW to get the number one contendership. As Ms. Muerte is ready for her biggest challenge ever in DCW. Looking ahead towards Destiny. As here comes the Women's Champion, Cassidy Webb. We had a hard fart match against Jamie Rabbit in the last episode a DCW Saturday Night Unleashed. Being the only women's champion so far here in DCW, defeating Akumi in the finals of the tournament at Summer Madness. Ms. Webb makes her way into the ring with the belt over her shoulder. Could this possibly be the last time that Cassidy Webb has that belt in her hands here tonight in Phoenix, Arizona. This has been an insane night here at DCW Drive. We already had one title change as Colonel Campano is the new DCW Internet Champion. As this matchup here is for the DCW Women's Championship between Cassidy Webb and Dama de la Muerte. Ms. Muerte has been waiting her whole life to make it to this point. Hoping to take this title to the underworld. And there goes the undisputed and only women's champion here in DCW, Cassidy Webb. As she sits there and flaunts the title in Ms. Muerte's face. As Ms. Webb holds the title out to the referee, possibly for the last time, showing Ms. Muerte what is the belt all about, what this matchup is all about, the women's championship. We still have a main event tonight, ladies and gentlemen, for the world championship between Isaac Najee and Leon Tyson. Here we go for the women's title. And there goes Muerte with a quick takedown on the Cassidy Webb. As Damon hitting her with boots to the back. Trying to take a quick opportunity in this matchup. With a quick DDT on the Cassidy Webb. And she's sitting here taunting Webb to get up. Webb's trying to crawl to her feet. She just kicks Ms. Webb back down to the mat. Damon sure seems pretty confident about herself tonight. As Cassidy with a shot. She follows it up with a backbreaker. Turning into a submission hold. Trying to wear down Dama de la Muerte. Irish whip goes to Muerte. Comes back around. Cassidy sets her up. Going for a neck breaker and connects it. Cassidy picking up Muerte. And Cassidy with a stunner mic maneuver. Taking her down. These two women seem to be on top of their games tonight. With a net breaker by Cassidy Webb, trying to soften up Muerte right now. Going for the second row splash and connects. Cassidy Webb so far in DCW has two successful title defenses. Once against Okumi on Saturday Night Unleashed. Another one, Jamie Rabbit at Vice. But she is facing the likes of Dama de la Muerte. Something that she ain't quite faced in DCW. As she throws Cassidy across the ring. Cassidy trying to get up to her feet. Muerte going for a boot. But Cassidy's back up. Cassidy going for an exploder suplex and it connects. Going for the cover. Not even a one count. And she kicks out. Cassidy can't even get a one count on her. Now going for boots. Kicking her all across the mat. A knee to the back. Cassidy's trying to make sure she has full control in this matchup to try to retain that title. Taunting Ms. Muerte. Throws her the top rope. Counter by Muerte. Comes back into the ring. Going for a neck breaker. She connects it. Connected, going for a neck breaker. Going for the cover. One count kick out by Cassidy. Cassidy with a kick out. Let you get her head thrown down to the mat. Muerte connecting with a slingshot splash. A rolling senton on the Cassidy Webb. Trying to work on the neck of Cassidy. Cassidy gets out of it. Snap near takedown. Trying to pick her up. Cassidy with a shot to the gut. Chuck over clothesline, ducked it. Muerte connects with a drop kick. Cassidy rolls out of the ring trying to recoup. I haven't seen Cassidy in this much trouble before in a matchup here in DCW. As he's trying to run away for Damo right now. Cassidy eyes with Damo to the corner. Cassidy's trying to take Damo up top. Cassidy's trying to go for it all here. Going for a superplex. She got her set up. Superplex by Cassidy Webb. Going for the cover. 1, 2. Kick out by Dama. Kick out by Dama. Cassidy continues work on the back. Now Cassidy got Dama locked in, but Dama quickly gets out of it. Cassidy the Irish whip. Comes back around. Try to pick up Dama. Dama counters. Dama trying to go in for Gary, but misses. Cassidy got her on the shoulder. Dama counters. Reverse DDT. Reverse DDT. Followed up by chops. Followed up by a lumbar check by Dama. As Dama seems like she's in full control after that lumbar check. Dama with boosted arm on the Cassidy, trying to set her up. What's Dama going for here? She's trying to get up for that powerbomb position. She's setting her up. She's locking Cassidy in. She drops Cassidy around her head, going for the cover. 1, 2. Three! And we have a new women's champion, Dama de la Muerte. Cassidy gave everything she had, hit her at an exploded suplex, but nothing was enough for Dama de la Muerte. Hit her with net breakers and lumbar checks, and that reverse powerbomb dropping. Cassidy on her head and taking her down for the 1, 2, and 3. That right there sealed the deal in the fate of Cassidy Webb. And we now have a new women's champion, Dama de la Muerte. Our last match of the evening is for the DCW World Championship. As the king of this ring, Leon Tyson, makes his way into the arena. These two men have a long history here in DCW, battling it out in various pay-per-views, having a best of three matchup. That Isaac Najic came out on top, being the last two men in DCW's King of Kings match, where Isaac Najic also won. But with this third part of this trilogy, be the one that will make Leon Tyson king. As Leon Tyson looks onto the crowd here in Phoenix, Arizona, and our main event of DCW Drive. Is any time to become champion, the time will be now for Leon Tyson to prove that he is truly the king of this ring. As Leon Tyson pacing back and forth in the ring, waiting for the king of DCW. to make his way down to the ring. He is your DCW King of Kings winner. He is your current DCW World Heavyweight Champion, Isaac Naje. Coming to the ring by Angelina Ali. That man has been through many obstacles to become the DCW World Champion. He had to go through the top best of this company twice to become champion. First, he had to go through the Kings of Kings to get an opportunity to face Will Nunn at Summer Madness, which in that great classic matchup, he came up just short. Maybe had another opportunity at DCW Vice at Las Vegas Roulette match, where he seemingly came out on top, literally came out of nowhere to take down Will Nunn and hit Eric Taylor with the Arabian Flight to become the DCW World Heavyweight Champion. And it is fitting that his first title defense is with the man that he has fought many times here at DCW. This matchup here is our main event, a DCW Drive, and it is for the DCW World Heavyweight Championship. Leon Tyson thinks he is ready to dethrone the king. He is ready to take over the throne as a DCW World Heavyweight Champion. As he holds his fist in the air. And there you have it right there, folks. Your DCW King of Kings winner and the current DCW World Champion, Isaac Naje, who's went through battles with the man that's across the ring from him. If there's any indication from the last fights that these two men have had each other, this match should be a classic here in DCW. As Isaac Naje gets the title to the referee shows the belt to Leon Tyson, showing everybody in Phoenix, Arizona, and in the world what our main event is about. It is for the DCW World Heavyweight Championship. It is Tyson, it is Naje, and here we go. As Naje takes down Tyson in the early goings of this matchup. These two men have been in the best of three series, but one of the matches ended up being a tie and had to go to overtime, which I believe that Isaac Naje won. As Naje picks up Tyson, he drops him down onto the mat with that suplex, dragging the king in this ring, the middle of the ring, working on the armor, Leon Tyson. Springboard moonsault by the self-proclaimed king of DCW, the king of Bollywood, Isaac Naje. With Angelina Ali's on the outside, looking on her man, defending this title. As Tyson reversed that boot, Tyson trying to go for a clothesline. Naje trying to go for a shot, but that was counter. And Tyson got an upper hand now with that net breaker. Now Tyson, we're gonna neck a Naje. He believes that this truly is his destiny to defeat Isaac Naje and become the third ever DCW World Champion. He hits a elbow drop for the second rope. Tyson picking up Naje off the ground. Tyson Irish whip. Naje comes back around. The two man bump heads. Naje trying to go for a quick suplex. Counter by Leon Tyson. Tyson with a big shot to the face. These two men know each other very well in that ring. Considering the war these two men have had, Leon Tyson is pointing to the crowd here. That's a fatal mistake. Since Naje hit him with a jawbreaker. But Tyson coming around with a clothesline. As Naje trying to take advantage of this matchup. Tyson with these haymakers onto Naje. Naje trying to fight back. Naje with a kick hurricanrana. Taking down the king of this ring. Naje on the second rope. Tyson tried to get on his feet. Tyson's up on his feet. Drop kick and a kick up by Isaac Nadje, showing his prowess in the ring right now. Nadje got Tyson up and drops onto the ropes. You can see Andre Aldina cheering on Isaac Nadje, and the crowd cheering on Nadje as well. Try to go for a boot on Tyson. Tyson out of the way. Nadje trying to stay right on top of him here. Goes into the turnbuckle. Trying to take up Tyson up top. Shot in the back by Nadje. Nadje going for a German. A German suplex on the top rope and he connects it. A German suplex by Isaac Nadje. Now we continue to work on the back of Leon Tyson. Tyson with a reverse DDT. Tyson's game plan seems to be to slow the matchup down, make the matchup go his pace, because Leon Tyson is clearly the more powerful of the two. But as powerful as Tyson is, it's how quick as Nadje is. It is a high flyer against a powerhouse here in our main event. Going for the cover is Tyson. One count kick out by Isaac Nadje. Tyson gonna do more than that to take down the King of Bollywood. As Tyson going for a reverse DDT, countering the slam that Nadja's going for. Nadje countering Tyson now. These 2 men just going back and forth in this matchup. Nadje picking up Tyson. Trying to go for a power bomb. Wait, a buckle bomb! A buckle bomb onto Tyson. Nadje keeps attacking in the back and the arms of Leon Tyson. Possibly making it difficult for Tyson. Hit the down with the King. But Tyson trying to get control in this matchup here. Tyson trying to sell him for a power bomb. Nadje counters it with shots. Tyson going for a cutter. Nadje counters. Nadje with an uppercut. Nadje with a back suplex to take down the King of this ring. As we look at the capacity crowd here in Phoenix, Arizona. Nadje with a suplex, taking him down. Going for the cover. One count kick out by Leon Tyson. Nadje on the second rope. Nadje going for it and missed it. Now Tyson going for the cover. One count kick out by Isaac Nadje. These 2 men will not stay down in our main event. A counter by Nadje takes down Tyson. Tyson takes down Nadje this time. What a great back and forth matchup in our main event. An elbow drop right into the back of Isaac Nadje. Nadje's back up to his feet. Tyson's trying to get up. The King of Bollywood trying to figure out his next move here in this matchup. He's stomping out Tyson, trying to stop the King of this ring for getting up. Work on the leg of Leon Tyson now. Tyson with a big boot to the face. Now Tyson work on the leg of Isaac Nadje now. Tyson with a shot to the midsection. Picks up Nadje, has him on the shoulders. And he hits him with a buckle bomb of his own. Covers Nadje. One count kick out by Isaac Nadje. One count kick out. Look at the arrogance of Tyson here. Bowing and curtsying to Isaac Nadje. Those moves were mistakes in the past, but will be a mistake in this matchup for him. As he drops Nadje onto the ropes. Tyson with a shot to the face. Tyson with a back suplex. Another back suplex. Hits him with a German. All hail King Tyson. We could be moments away from a new world champion. But Nigel's on the offensive now. Tyson counters with a DDT. Tyson's getting ready for Najee. Najee's on his feet. Down with the King. It's over. New champion. 1, 2, 3. No. 2 3/4. The closest pinfall of the night. And somehow, Najee kicks out of Down with the King. Tyson's trying to work down Isaac some more, but Najee with headshots. Najee trying to set him over the back suplex and connects. Najee somehow on his feet, barely escaping with Down with the King. Najee's going up top. What is he going to do? Tyson trying to crawl to his feet. But Najee's there to meet him. Missing up the driver. Going with a cover. One count kick out by Tyson. Tyson with a quick kick out. Back suplex by, no, reverse. Back suplex by Tyson. Najee's going for a back suplex. But Tyson countered into his own back suplex. Tyson knocks Najee to the outside. A crazy back and forth main event of an exciting pay-per-view here at DCW Drive. A shot in the face. We're at a count of three here. The two men battle it out on the floor. Najee throws Tyson back in. Tyson keeps favoring that back of his. Going for the cover. Not even one count. Not even a one count, and Tyson kicks out. Najee trying to keep Tyson down. Shot in the back. Najee setting up to take him down. Najee with a boot to the back. Going for the dragon sleeper. He barely has it locked in. He barely has the hole locked in. Tyson with knees to get out of the hold. Najee trying to set up Tyson running to the turnbuckle. Running power slam by Najee. Najee busting out moves never seen from him before. Najee from the second rope and it connects this time. The crowd is on his feet for our main event. This is for the DCW World Championship. Back suplex by Leon Tyson. Dropping Najee on his head. Going for the cover. One count kick out by Isaac Najee. I don't know what more Leon Tyson can do here. Leon Tyson keeps focusing on the neck and the shoulders area of Isaac Najee. Trying to soften him up again for the Down with the King. Snapping their takedown. And back to working on that neck again. Like I said, this is the game plan that Tyson had all along. Having at a slow pace. But Najee gets out of that hold. Najee rolls out trying to regroup. Tyson follows him to the outside. Referee starts his count. And Tyson drops Isaac Najee onto the apron. And he keeps taunting Isaac Najee throughout this match. We're at a count of three. Take down by Najee. Shot in the face. We're at a count of four. Run the floor. We're at a count of five now. Shot in the face by Leon Tyson. Count of six. Najee's back in. Tyson's back in. Tyson knew that he had to pin or make Nandi submit to become the world champion. Cover by Tyson. 1, 2, kick out by Najee. Kick out by Najee. Tyson with boots to the back. Irish whip to the corner. Shot to the back. Tyson dropping Najee onto the turnbuckle. Najee trying to roll out. Comes back in. Najee Irish whips Tyson to the corner. Najee trying to pick up Leon Tyson into the top rope. Whoa! Isaac Najee with the top rope. Hurricanrana and a Najee salt. A Najee salt by Najee. As he works on a knee on Leon Tyson. This could be the end for the Kang of this ring. Going for the cover. Referee just standing there. Referee should go down for the count. The referee didn't get down for the count. What was that? Najee's up top. Arabian Flight. No, he missed. Najee missed the Arabian Flight. Najee takes down Tyson. Najee couldn't go for the cover. That took all out of him. That took everything out of him. Hit the Arabian Flight. Tyson's trying to take control. Tyson going for down with the King. Reversed by Najee. Najee reversed down with the King. Najee takes down Tyson. Najee can barely get to his feet. Najee trying to set him up. Najee trying to lock it in. The Jaguar in clutch. The Jaguar in clutch. Tyson has nowhere to go. Tyson taps out. Leon Tyson taps out. Isaac Najee is still your DCW World Heavyweight Champion. Najee had enough energy to lock in the Jaguar in clutch. And Tyson couldn't hold on any longer. So they had to tap out. The King of Bollywood is still the King of DCW. What an incredible matchup against these two fierce competitors. Thank you everybody for joining us here at DCW Drive. We'll see you next time.